Hi guys, it's Marty here, and in this video we're going to be covering how to install WordPress, which is the first step to building a WordPress website. This video is totally up to date for 2022, and as it's a tutorial for beginners, I'm going to try to keep everything as simple as possible. Okay, so before we can install WordPress, we first need to register a domain name and web hosting. Now, there are tons of different places we can get these from, but I personally recommend a company called HostGator. I've been using them for years now without any problems. They're a well-known hosting company with affordable pricing and great support, which is exactly what we want when getting started. So if you don't already have a domain name and web hosting, just click the hosting link in the description below. Clicking through this link will also get you a great discount on your hosting as well. Then we're going to click Get Started, and here we can choose the hosting plan we want. If we're only building one website, we can go for the Hatchling plan, or if we want to build more than one website, go for the Baby plan. Once we've decided on which one we want, we can click Buy Now underneath. Now on this page, we're going to type the domain name we're wanting to register into this box at the top, and then choose our domain extension using the drop-down on the right. So the domain name I'm registering here is websiteaboutcoffee.com. Then once we're done here, we can scroll down to where it says Domain Privacy Protection. This is an optional add-on, and I normally just uncheck this box myself and haven't had any problems to date. But if you're trying to keep your site totally anonymous, just leave this box checked. Then under this on the right, we can choose how often we'd like to pay for our hosting. And I'm going to set mine to 12 months. Then under this we need to enter our email address and create a password and security pin for our account. And then we're going to enter our billing information under this. Once we're done here, if we scroll down, we'll see a section called Add Additional Services. Personally, I don't want any of these, so I'm just going to uncheck them. Then the last thing we want to do is review our order and make sure everything's correct. And as long as it is, we can check the box at the bottom to agree to their terms, and then click Check Out Now. Then, after paying for our order, we'll find ourselves logged into the HostGator dashboard, and from here we're going to click Launch cPanel on the right, which is going to open up the HostGator cPanel. Then we're going to type WordPress into the search bar here at the top, and click on WordPress Manager by Softaculous. Now we need to click Install, and this will open up the WordPress installer. Here we want to make sure our new domain name is selected in this box at the top, and the box beside it is left blank. Then under this we can enter our site name, and our site description. But don't worry too much about either of these for now, as we can always change them again later. Now on the right, we're going to enter the username and password we want for logging into our WordPress site. And then under this, we can update our email address. Then once we're done here, we're going to leave everything else as it is, scroll down to the very bottom, and click Install. WordPress is then going to be installed for us automatically, and this will usually take less than a minute. Once it's finished, it'll say congratulations, the software was installed. At this point, we can click the link beside where it says admin URL, which is going to bring us to the WordPress dashboard. And this is where we can add any content or make any changes to our new WordPress site, which is now live online. All we need to do to visit it is click our site title in the top left, and this is going to show us what WordPress looks like when we first install it. Don't worry if yours looks a little different than mine, as sometimes they change up the default theme. Either way, it's just going to have some demo content on it for now, but it's ready for us to start customizing and adding content to. Then, if we want to get back to the dashboard, we just need to click our site title again in the top left. So that's us now at the end of this video, and that was how to install WordPress for beginners. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you for watching my video.